morning, everybody. Firstly, I'd like to acknowledge the traditional owners of this land. Secondly, on behalf of U3A Hobart, we'd like to welcome all of Ken's family and fan club who have turned out. Thirdly, please either turn your phones off or turn them to silent. So welcome everyone to this piano recital by Ken Chilcott. Most of you will know that this is the third of these recitals, and the fact that this hall is just about full is a tribute to the success of the 2021 and 2022 recitals. Actually, the occasion is the 2023 annual Roy and Maureen Davies Memorial Lecture. The Davies were long-term members of U3A Hobart, and they helped ensure its longevity with a substantial bequest. The then committee decided to establish an annual lecture by a prominent Tasmanian in memory of Roy and Maureen. Now Ken has been a U3A member for many years, and we're delighted that he's agreed to perform once again for us on this important occasion. Ken is not going to lecture us, but rather to entertain us in his wonderfully professional way. So let's give Ken a warm welcome.
Imbibing in Chopin vodka for breakfast and visiting his grave in a Paris cemetery. I am a Chopin addict. I will start with two short preludes. The first one is known as the chord prelude, and then one used as part of the ballet score. Then follows a mazurka, which is a Polish dance, and if you listen carefully, you may hear a bit of Turkish influence.
Thank you. Thank you.
nocturnes are popular among Chopin's compositions. A nocturne, of course, is music of the night. A single line of melody from the right hand, with the left hand providing lots of beautiful harmony. Nocturnes should be listened to by candlelight to create a feeling of peace and excluding all outside influences. In all of his nocturnes, Chopin brings in an element of surprise towards the end, perhaps to wake the sleeping listener. This is one of his most popular, the nocturne in E flat major.
Thank you.
My music agenda for 2023 includes a visit to Sydney in July, where I will be an audience member for the Sydney International Piano Competition, usually held every 4 years. I love piano competitions. Over just 13 days, I will attend 30 competition sessions, each in about 2 hours. 32 pianists selected from 250 applications from all over the world will compete. Their numbers gradually whittled down to a final six, who will be performing concertos accompanied by the Sydney Symphony Orchestra in the recently renovated Opera House Concert Hall. This will be the sixth time I've attended this competition. Exciting times ahead. We're now going to look at the music of Edvard Grieg, Norway's most famous composer, born 1843, just a century before me. One of his compositions for piano is called Wedding Day at Trolltower, written as a present for his wife Nina on their silver wedding anniversary. The piece is in three parts. Firstly, the arrival of the wedding guests and their celebrations on the village green. Then the ceremony in the church, and you might hear some bells. And then the rowdy party continues. Wedding Day at Trolltower.
Thank you.
the brilliant Australian pianist and composer Percy Grainger, who gave many performances of Grieg's famous piano concerto. Grieg is quoted as saying, "I have written music that no one in my country can play, and here comes this Australian who plays them as well as they ought to be played. He is a genius." Grainger was a gatherer of folk tunes from various countries, including England. He composed arrangements of many of them. Here is my arrangement of one of Percy's arrangements. You might also hear some bells. Today is the 9th of February and somebody here is celebrating a birthday. Where are you, Christine? Can you stand up? Christine? Where are you? Let's have a look at you. I'll let you sit down straight away. She's shy. Anyway, it's Christine's birthday and we're going to sing to her. Thank you. composer of military marches was the American John Philip Sousa. Among his popular marches are The Stars and Stripes Forever and The Liberty Bell. The Liberty Bell was the name of a famous US warship, and of course there was a bell on the deck which was rung on formal occasions, mostly to accompany the ship's band. I have made an arrangement of this march, and my long-term friend of almost 70 years, Ross Buckley, is going to become a temporary campanologist and ring the bell. Come on up, Ross. Give him a welcome. Now, this is the first time that Ross has actually seen this bell. We haven't actually rehearsed what we're going to play. So, to give Ross a feel of the bell, give it a bell.
I thought it was going to be like this. What am I supposed to do with this?
Yeah. Loudly. Just pull it.
Towards me.
Towards you.
Oh, doesn't work.
Pederast is